Hi there, Doug Stimmon with IT Creations. I have a high-density server from Gigabyte today, the Gigabyte H263-S63. This unit features a 2U chassis with four individual server nodes, each node with dual fourth or fifth generation Intel Xeon scalable processors, plus support for up to 4 terabytes of memory. Max processors are supported too, but only on certain configurations, which we will get into. Storage on the front is equally divided between the server nodes. Like our channel? Hit that subscribe button, or even ring that bell thing up there if you want notifications. I mean, everyone's interested in servers, right? Yeah, right. Anyways, let's get to it. This platform is designed for high-performance computing, or HPC, and for hyper-converged infrastructures, or HCI. With HPC applications, we're talking AI, deep learning, and scientific analysis, or it can be converted to a software-defined cluster for compute, storage, networking, or virtualization in a scale-out hyperconverged infrastructure. Very flexible. There are actually 4 different configurations for Gigabyte's H263-S63 server. Well, maybe just 2 main differences. Those would be more of an optional configuration with other manufacturers. The AAN1 and the AAW1 each support air cooling, while the LA1 and LAW1 configurations feature optional liquid cooling. In each of those categories, there are 2 different power supply units, with one supporting 2600 watt PSUs and the other 3000 watts. We have the AAW1 variant with air cooling and 3000 watt PSUs. Starting on the back of the system, those 3000 watt PSUs stacked on the left have dynamic current limiting technology, or DCL, to shield power supplies from overcurrent faults. Apparently, DCL is only available on the 3000 watt PSUs. Next to those on the left, there is a single chassis management controller port, or CMC port. You can install an optional ring topology kit in that little space directly below the CMC port. That would allow administrators to daisy chain several of these chassis together. In fact, you can add a third PSU to the mix, offering 2+1 redundancy in the space right below the CMC port and optional ring topology port. To the right of the PSUs, the 4 server nodes. Each of the 4 server nodes has a dedicated IPMI LAN port to access the integrated ASSPEED AST2600 baseboard management controller. Then a VGA port, dual USB 3.2 Gen 1 ports, and an ID button with integrated LED. There are 2 rear accessible PCI slots on top and an OCP 3.0 Gen 5 by 16 slot on the bottom. Are you interested in the high-density Gigabyte H263-S63 server? If you are, then for a limited time, you can save up to $500 off a system that's listed or one that you can configure at IT Creations that's valued at $5,000 or more. Just click that link for more information. When you're ready to make a purchase, just mention this video. You could be the proud owner of this 2U Hyper server. If it was a person and it had 4 nodes or 4 personalities, they might suffer from hallucinations and delusions. Thankfully, that's not the case with servers. In this case, you could support 4 or more different workloads or link those personalities or nodes together for even greater brain power. Thankfully, it's not a person. On the front of the system, there are 8 NVMe SAS SATA drive bays with a perforated panel between each pair of drives for airflow. The drive bays are equally divided between the server nodes, with 2 assigned per node, starting with node 1 on the left through node 4 on the right. With SAS drives, you will need a storage controller, but the system will accommodate NVMe or SATA natively. If you do go with NVMe, there is an optional kit featuring drive trays with neon green release tabs. To either side are control panels for 2 server nodes. Each has a power on button and unit ID button with integrated LED. Above those, a system status LED with reset button beside that. Additionally, on the right server ear, there is an enclosure status LED and a CMC reset button. With the chassis management controller, or CMC, the individual server nodes are connected internally for easy management of the entire chassis, plus less cables and switches to deal with. That optional ring topology kit adds another RJ45 port right below the CMC port, enabling several multi-node chassis to be daisy-chained together, again reducing wiring and the need for additional switches. Each of the servers can also be managed individually if you plan to use a more traditional network topology. In that case, the Gigabyte Management Console, which is preloaded on each system, and then of course, Gigabyte Server Management, or GSM, for managing clusters of servers simultaneously using a standard browser. Removing the top cover panel, you can see the 2 top server nodes that plug into the mid-plane board just behind a bank of 8 80mm high-performance fans. The mid-plane board also has the connectors for the upfront drives. All server nodes are removable from the back of the chassis using the lever. Each of the server nodes has a small fan duct to help direct fresh air over the CPUs and memory module slots. Depending on your expansion needs, there are a few optional risers with two low-profile PCI 5.0x16 slots and the PCI 5.0x16 OCP card slot per node. That would be the default, but only on the AAN1 and the AAW1 variants. The LAN1 and LAW1 lose a PCI slot as liquid cooling units exit through the top left PCI slot and back. On this system, the H263-S63 AAW1, there is one PCI slot above the OCP card slot and another right beside it. There is an option for just a single Gen 5x16 PCI per node that can potentially be paired with a PCI riser supporting up to four M.2 slots featuring a Gen 4x4 interface for each drive. That could come in handy given the limited storage available on this system, although it really depends on what applications you will be running and what kind of workloads these units will be performing. There is another optional PCI 4.0 slot kit with a x4 link width for support of a single M.2 drive. Two more expansion slots are located beside each of the CPUs and memory modules. Those ones are not clearly defined as far as the usage on this system goes. That single OCP mezzanine card slot on the bottom will limit the CPU TDP on the AAN1 and the AAW1 server variants. You can have the OCP card slot and both PCI slots as long as the TDP does not exceed 225 watts. With a 270 watt CPU TDP, the OCP card is not supported with either one or two PCI slots. This is not the case with the LAN1 and LAW1 variants, which allow CPUs up to 385 watts. Regardless, featuring a Gen 5 PCI slot with a x16 link width and the newer OCP 3.0 card format, it offers easy installation from the back. Just unscrew the cover panel and slide the card into the slot until it's firmly attached to the connector on the motherboard. Secure it with a screw. With 4th Gen Intel Xeon Scalable processors, there are 8 memory channels per CPU, with each in charge of 8 memory module slots for a total of 16 memory module slots with both CPUs and one DIMM per channel. 5th Gen Intel Xeon Scalable CPUs have 12 memory channel architecture, which will not provide any benefit given there are only 8 memory module slots per CPU. That said, there is an increase in compute performance and memory speed from 4800 MHz to 5600 MHz. This system is outfitted with dual 4th Gen Intel Xeon Scalable 4410Y processors with 12 cores, 30 megabytes of L3 cache, and a TDP of 150 watts from the silver category. Given that, memory speed is also limited to 4000 MHz. We've installed 16 gigabyte memory modules operating at up to 4800 MHz, but you won't get that memory speed because of the supported speed of the CPU at 4000 MHz. The other two liquid-cooled versions with the suffix LAN1 and LAW1 also support Intel Xeon's CPU Max series processors. These processors are designed to accommodate high-performance computing workloads and offer high-bandwidth memory for data-intensive workloads, modeling, AI, deep learning, that kind of thing. Only up to 56 cores, while Gen 4 Xeon support up to 60, and Gen 5 up to 64 cores, but again, there is a TDP limit for AAW1 platforms of 225 watts or 270 watts if you forgo the OCP card. The two liquid-cooled versions, LAN1 and LAW variants, will support dual CPUs with a TDP of up to 385 watts for basically more cores in all categories. 4th and 5th Gen CPUs do range from 125 watts up to 350 watts, but the CPU Max series all have a TDP of 350 watts across the board in all SKUs. I do hope you enjoyed this Hyper Gigabyte H263-S63 server offering up to 4 dual socket server nodes in its 2U chassis. I always marvel at the engineering that goes into these tightly compact units, but then you have to think of the software that makes it all function as kind of a cohesive unit. Impressive to say the least. If you are looking for one of these systems, or something like it, check out IT Creations, purveyors of fine servers, workstations, plus other hard-to-find parts and components. Think about subscribing to our channel. It could be good for both of us. Till next time, I'm Doug Stuman with IT Creations. Thanks for watching.